Sheriff Nancy with the Pierce County Sheriff's Department. First and foremost, I'd like to say our thoughts and prayers are with the families that were involved in this accident. And the information we're about to give you is what we're going to give you at this time. It's still under investigation, so there's some things we will not release. Thursday, December 12, 2013, at 3:41 p.m., the Pierce County Sheriff's Office was notified of a two-vehicle accident on Highway 35 near 468th Avenue near Prescott, Wisconsin, in Oak Grove Township. After sheriff's deputies arrived on the scene, it was learned that a southbound vehicle driven by a Carrie Milberg, 22 of Centuria, Wisconsin, was operating a 2005 Saturn View SUV, collided with a northbound straight truck driven by Jose Mendoza, 24, from Rockford, Illinois. Initial investigation determined that the Milberg vehicle had rotated sideways across the roadway into the path of the straight truck. The northbound truck then collided with the rear of the Milberg vehicle in the northbound lane. There were no injuries to the three occupants in the straight truck. There were five occupants in the Saturn View. The driver, Carrie Milberg, reported from the scene to Regents Hospital in St. Paul, Minnesota, by North Memorial Air Care with undetermined injuries. A five-year-old female, niece of Ms. Milberg, was transported from the scene by North Memorial Air Care to Regents Hospital, also with undetermined injuries. A three-year-old son of Ms. Milberg was transported from the scene also to Regents Hospital with undetermined injuries. A second five-year-old niece of Ms. Milberg was transported from the scene by ground ambulance to River Falls Area Hospital, where she was pronounced dead as a result of her injuries. An 11-year-old daughter of Ms. Milberg, was pronounced dead at the scene, although initially appeared as though roadway conditions were not a contributing factor to the accident, is not fully determined or ruled out at this time. The Wisconsin State Patrol will be conducting an accident reconstruction of this incident that will assist Pierce County in determining a more definite cause and manner of the accident. Do we have any questions?
Can you kind of slowly explain in regular people terms exactly what she did in the truck? And I'm using my hands.
Basically, the truck was heading what we would call northbound on 35, north or westbound, because it kind of 35 kind of runs kind of north and west together. So the truck was heading northbound, the car was heading southbound. It appears that she, for some reason, had lost control, going sideways into the lane of the truck, and at that point she was spun several times before the car came to rest.
Were all the children in the car and the driver, did they remain in the car? Were they belted or were they ejected?
Ms. Milberg was ejected from the vehicle.
And she's 22?
32.
Yes.
Were the kids in car seats? Were they in? They belted in or properly secured into the car?
At this time, I don't know about properly, but they were all in car seats. It's still all under investigation.
And how do you know, or how are you able to determine that weather was probably not a factor?
That'll all come back when all the reports come in from all the officers that when they arrived on scene. And do you ever totally know? You probably maybe never will. Unless Ms. Milberg can speak and tell us in her own words afterwards.
You haven't been able to speak to her. She's not able to speak yet.
Correct.
You know the conditions of anybody involved so far? What is the latest release?
As far as I've been told, critical on the Ms. Milberg and the five-year-old daughter, and I do not know on the three-year-old.
The niece.
Niece.
And I'm sure on the three-year-old son.
Correct.
Any indication of alcohol, drugs, anything like that?
It's all being investigated at this time.
Working a case like this with kids, I know it gets so many people's attention. Has it been kind of traumatic for your deputies?
It's been very traumatic, not only for the deputies, but for the whole community. I had the luxury today to teach DARE over in Prescott, Wisconsin, where the four-year-old attended school, the 4K. And the teachers are shook, the families are shook, neighbors, friends, EMS, fire, everybody's that was there. Our people, we've been doing everything we can to try to help them out and get them through this. When it comes to dealing with kids, it's very tough on everybody.
Can you tell us where these children attended school? You sort of mentioned one
One is Prescott area, and the rest are up in Polk County area, is where they're from.
Any specific names, though, of the schools?
No, I do not know.
Are you releasing the name of the children?
We are not at this time.
How about the people in Mendoza's semi? Are they sitting? I'm just curious. Three people in a semi, is that normal? Are there enough seats for a semi-truck like that? Are you revealing the identities of these people?
We are not revealing their identities because they are witnesses at this time, and it's still all under investigation.
Will they be ticketed, or does it seem like they might have done any? I mean,
at this time, I cannot tell you that. Do not know.
Do we know where she was headed? Was she coming home from school, headed to work, headed home?
As far as I know, she was heading to her sister's house, but unknown if that was the exact location. That's what we've been told so far.
Where's sister's? What city?
Prescott.
And can you say one more time for me, on 35 near 468?
68, yes, correct.
468?
468.
Avenue. Near, it's a town.
So. Avenue.
Do you know if those nieces are twins?
No, they're not.
And then the four-year-old, or the three of them siblings, though?
Two of them are siblings.
And then another one?
Two are relatives.
Is Mr. Mendoza making some type of delivery? Was he working for a specific company at the time? Was he on the job? Where was he headed? Where was he coming from?
He was on the job, but I do not know at this time of the delivery. It's all under investigation where he was coming from, where he's going to.
Is this a trouble area? Are there a number of accidents along this bend or along this stretch of roadway?
Highway 35 is always a busy stretch for us because it's kind of people from Minnesota take it, run the river down when they're touring the lake or the river. In the summertime, it gets very busy with motorcycles, so we do have a lot of accidents along Highway 35, and that goes through the whole county, not just that chunk, though.
What's the speed limit in that area?
55.
It's the last time an accident like this happened in that area. We spoke to a neighbor who sent us photos of a semi that had actually rolled over. Can you recall when the last time something like this has happened in that area? Is this an area of no frequent accidents?
I wouldn't say that area is known for frequent accidents. That whole stretch of 35, it's windy. People are looking at, you know, whatever it may be at the time of the year, if it's leaves or if it's the river. So it's one of those, and it gets very highly traveled by non-locals, I should say, not residents. So that makes it also a contributing factor because they don't know the road, they don't know how the corners handle, how the, you know, everything goes. So that makes everything gets thrown into a big pot, kind of. And yes, it is a very busy stretch of our county.
Is there a thought of vehicle failure, like a flat tire or anything like that, that could possibly send her into the other lane?
That's all being on control, and they're doing the investigation with us.
How long do you expect that to take?
Hang on.
How long do those things typically take?
Boy, it could take quite a while by the time they go through everything and reconstruct the accident.
How much time did Mendoza have?
As from the investigation I've seen right now, there was not a lot of time, but we will know more in the future.
So which side of the road actually had the guardrail? Was that the southbound side then? Because I noticed the other side doesn't have a guardrail.
Correct. So
it'd be this. Which one is northbound, which one's southbound?
Northbound is going towards Prescott.
Guardrail.
And that's the side that has a guardrail, northbound side.
Sorry.
Yes.
So is it, just to be crystal clear, is northbound, would that downhill or is that uphill?
Northbound would actually be going downhill.
Okay.
Southbound is going uphill in that area. And so that 35 is kind of confusing because it does run east and west also.
And just to confirm, it was a 5-year-old female who was a niece, a 3-year-old son, another 5-year-old niece, and 11-year-old daughter.
Correct.
And the 3-year-old son and the 11-year-old daughter, those were hers, and the other two were her nieces.
Correct.
Do you know the location of who is who? Were the children who were deceased, were they in a middle seat and others were in the back? Do you know who was where?
I do not know. That's still under investigation also.
Okay.
Just because the firemen got there, everybody started helping everybody, and so they're still doing reports and investigating that whole thing and where everybody was sitting.
I'm sorry, I don't know if you've said this already, but the two nieces in the vehicle, do they belong to the sister she was going to go visit?
They belong to two separate sisters.
Two separate sisters.
Right.
So the sister that she was going to go visit, these nieces do not belong to her at all?
Yes, one does.
One does, sorry.
So three different families represented in the back of this.
Correct.
Okay. And did they do carpool, or was she, was it a normal occurrence for her?
As of right now, it's not still all under investigation.
You may have said this already, because you said Carrie was ejected. Does that mean she wasn't wearing a seatbelt?
I can't totally say that, but she was ejected from the vehicle.
Have you been in touch with parents, or who all have you guys been working with through this process? It's curious.
We've been working with Carrie's parents, Carrie's family. They've been very, very supportive and helpful in anything we've been asking and trying to put the puzzle together, basically. So they're very supportive, but they've got a lot going on right now, too. A lot of thoughts and prayers going through their family. So.
And do you know of anything? Because people always ask when they hear stories like this if they can help or do anything. What could you say for this community right now?
Right now, just thoughts and prayers and support. It's a holiday season. You hate to see anything like this happen during the holiday season. Right now, it's just thoughts and prayers and get them through to see what's going to happen in the future here. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
See you next update.